So for US citizens or the green card holders, it's very good now. But for the people who are coming on this H, what H1,
H1.
right? Yeah, it's not good because I have some of friends are staying in US, but they used to complain they are not able to get a job. You know, let me. Yeah, should I start or anybody else also join Kalyan? Can you confirm, please? Please start the session. Remove student will join 30 minutes. Okay, so what I'll do, let me explain. Okay, here. And just show my screen. Okay, show my screen system. So now you can see my screen, right?
Yes.
Okay. Okay, so as I explained, okay, now it's okay. So as I explained yesterday also, that the understanding of real estate market is different in different region or different country in the world. Okay, so when we are talking about real estate in India, it means they are always talking about the construction industry. Because lease in and lease out, it's not organized market in India, right? So normally people will not understand lease in, renting, rent in or rent out concept as a formal way. Okay, it's because there it is not, or there was this was not properly organized. Even still, it is not this much of organized so that people are aware about it or not. Okay, but out of India. Like out of Asia, I can say the real estate meaning is different. Okay, means once this is purely related for the renting purpose, rent in, rent out. That is the basic things which we have in the real estate. So whenever we are going for any real estate project in India, okay, so how they're understanding that consultant will come and will take care all the requirement from starting when the company is even purchasing a land. For constructing any project, whether it is a commercial or retail or residential, okay, then he should be aware about the process, then construction process, then after that, once my product is ready, then he should help us to rent out or rent in scenarios to understand and to make it implement in the system. So this is a normal requirement. But if you go in like this Singapore or Australia or out of India or out of Asia. So the proper meaning, it is apart from the construction, then whatever we have to rent in or rent out process that is relevant to real estate only. So SAP also kept the solution according to the standard, the rent in or rent out practice. Okay, so purely it is designed for the same purpose. So when we are talking about any process in real estate, it is a start from the creation of master data. Okay, then it is moving further. Okay, so in real estate, we don't have any its own organization structure. We have to use the other's organization structure. Okay, controlling area, company code, whatever, wherever we are creating the object for the accounting purpose. Okay. So here in this PPT, I try to explain how we can understand the practice of any real estate industry from starting. Starting means like, let's say I'm a company, I'm an organization, and I'm having a different type of portfolio in my organization. Just take example of Godrej. Godrej in India, this company is purely in electronics, right? Electronics manufacturing items. And later on, they entered in the real estate also. Okay, real estate, I don't think they enter, like it's only 20 years or 15 or 20 years back only they entered in the real estate market, 15 years back. But before that, it was a purely electronics company who they were producing, they were manufacturing the electronics items only. So when they are defining any portfolio, whether they should enter in this market or not, so it is as per the strategies and objective of the organization always. So before entering in any business, that management has to decide whether we should enter in this particular portfolio or in this particular business or not. So there are some parameters. Based on that, they are deciding their strategies and their objectives. Okay. So if you see the organization wise, like Godrej, they used to do only premium class projects. They are not in middle or they are not in affordable residential house. Okay. So it means it's their strategy. They have to follow their strategy, and that's why they are constructing premium class projects only. Okay. So what they are doing, how they're deciding, it is based on their strategy and their vision or mission, you can say completely. So the process start from the portfolio when they are creating a new portfolio, when they are entering in that particular market. And after that, they are deciding what type of project they need to do. So if they are planning to do any premium class projects, it means it has to be in premium class city. It should not be like B grade city or C grade city as per the grade system within India or world, any part of the world. And accordingly, then they are deciding the location. So for premium class projects, they are taking very premium class lands or plots to construct the project. And once they are deciding to construct, then they are making a detailed plan. Okay. And after that, they are executing the project and constructing the apartment or commercial project or retail. Right. So the process, which is started from the defining the strategy and to construct the project. Okay. This comes under the EPPM, Enterprise Portfolio Project Management. That is a portfolio management. There is one project management is involved here in process, and project system is involved here. Once product is ready, once your project is ready, your product means your rental unit is ready, then the job will start in the REFX. Okay. So what exactly happen in REFX? Let's say we will take example of Godrej itself. They are constructing, they have constructed apartment, and let me open here because you are alone, so let me take it more interactive, this one. Okay, so let's say they have constructed one apartment. Okay, this is one apartment and this is another building. Okay, but for this they are considering only, sorry, so this is their project, and here in this project, okay, so let's say they are developing one township, complete township. Okay, and let's say this is a township one, and within this township they have constructed building one, and this is a building two. Okay, and within this building again they have constructed different floors. Okay, so this is one floor, or directly I should take this one as a apartment. Let's say this is a apartment one, and similarly they will have other apartment also, apartment two. Okay, sorry, I'm getting some issue here. Copy here. Okay, so I'm just taking this two apartments here, only two flats. So
Mm-hmm.
here, once the construction is ready and we are we this the project is ready for use, okay, or you can say it is handed over. Okay, in that case, we need to create a master project. We need to create a the master data within REFX. So what is the master data here? This is the project township. This is my complete project township, and this will create it as a business entity. Okay, and within this business entity, we need to create a building. Okay, so this is a building one, this is a building two, and within a building we need to create an apartment. Okay, so that will become our rental unit. Rental unit one, rental unit two, rental unit three, rental unit four, likewise. Okay, similarly, if we are having any parking area, we can create it as a land. Okay, so land, again, let's say I'm taking one example. I've constructed one parking area here. Okay, so how the master data will be available here? The business entity will be here, township one. Under that we will have building one, building two, and land. Land is my parking area. And again, within a building one, we will have the rental unit, apartment one and apartment two. Okay, and again, if we are again going to for within the land, then rental space will be the unit where we are applying our contract of the rent. Okay, so this is just idea how we are creating a master data here within REFX. So let me explain it in terms of here introduction. So how the cycle is moving, real estate life cycle management. Okay, here we need to first plan investment and monitor construction projects. Okay, so means before even constructing the project, we are planning the investment. Okay, and mm-hmm. these things we are doing in the investment and construction. Okay, or mm-hmm. we can say in another terms, in investment management and with reference to the project system, or portfolio project management with reference to the project system, we can achieve this.
Mm-hmm.
Next is promote vacant space via campaign, identify leads and provide lease offer to prospective tenants. So here, when the construction is ready, the master data has to be prepared in the system, then the CRM team has to do the campaign, right? They have to do the campaign to lease out the project. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
So here, identify leads and provide lease offer to prospective tenants. So what they will, there can be two scenarios. They can plan any campaign and they can call the prospects in that particular campaign, and whatever the questions they are getting from the different prospective, they can answer at the same time. And deal also can happen the same time. If you see in the India, the real estate company used to have some fair, real estate fair. Okay, mm-hmm. and all the prospect are coming in that fair, and if they are getting good offer that time, they are confirming their unit also. Okay, mm-hmm. so they are doing the campaign. So all these details they can have in the CRM system.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, commercial relationship management here, customer relationship management here, and this CRM can be integrated with REFX. Okay, let mm-hmm. me put one example here. Let's say your master data is ready and your CRM team is also ready, having all the data. And somebody is calling to the CRM team that I need one apartment. There's a 2 BHK, should have 1600 square feet of area, and it should be near to school, it should be near to railway station or airport. Okay, so CRM mm-hmm. team, first of all, he will maintain the details of the prospect in the system, in CRM system. Okay, and with reference to that, they can create a request with an REFX, and they can get the relevant unit which is suitable for him. Okay, and the same time or later on also, they can send to the prospect a mail, or they can communicate anyhow by letter or whatever, that these are the offer available with us, and you just come to the office and negotiate with us or discuss with us. So the prospect will come to the office and they will negotiate and finalize it. So once it is finalized, that directly contract can be created, having the different conditions and the timelines. So that is the things which we have here. So CRM, can be integrated with REFX here. Okay, and manage lease including posting and rent escalation, sales based rent and service charge settlement. So once the contract we are creating with an REFX, whenever once the search is ready to propose to any prospect, so it means this is a part of REFX. Before that, all the data maintenance of the prospect and the other information we are keeping in the CRM system. So this part comes under the REFX. Then manage space including move and room reservation. So this comes again REFX. There is one functionality of room reservation where we can reserve any let's say any meeting room within an organization, and with the timelines we can reserve it. But it's not flexible like how we have in the Outlook, okay? But we can manage it. We can see the usability of particular area. Next is handle work order for maintenance and repair. Okay, so here, let's say in the same example, this is apartment, okay? And let's say we are providing fully furnished apartment to our tenants. So in that case, this apartment will have other equipment also. It will have refrigerator, it will have TV, it will have sofa, it will have all the furnitures. So what we can do, we can integrate this REFX master data with plant maintenance master data. Okay, so in plant maintenance data, what we can do, we can create a function location for the building. And for each floors, we can create a further function location. And apartment one can be a last level of function location. For we can respect to how many one second, please. Yeah, sorry. So here what we can do, let's say if you are getting an issue in any equipment, so you can directly call to the facility management company who is providing the facility to your building, okay, within your building. So you can directly call that I'm getting some issues here in this equipment, and they will create one notification. They will ask some information. Tell me your unit number. Tell me your building number. Okay, tell me your project number. So all information they will get, and they will search in the system, and directly they will reach here on this rental unit. And let's say you are saying that TV is not working. So they will select the TV equipment within a system and will create one notification. Okay. So within a notification, the maintenance team will visit the site, and they will check whether everything is fine or not. And whatever the issue is there, they will rectify it. Okay. If any cost is incurring to rectify it, they can create a notification with respect. They can create a maintenance order with respect to this notification. So whatever cost is incurring, they will capture on the maintenance order. And finally, this maintenance order cost can be settled to my rental unit. So this provision I am having here. So this is the part which is communicated here. Handle work order for the maintenance and repair.
Okay.
Yeah. Next, investment and construction. Already I have explained this. Collect all investment ideas, approval steps and decision criteria. Create project and track budget, milestone deliverables and delivery dates. Electronically invites bids from the suppliers. Award contract, handle purchase order. So all the construction activities we are doing in investment and construction. Sales and marketing.
So we are those doing the activities are happening in project system, right?
Yeah. Project system.
Okay.
So how exactly the process is moving here? See,
do you have a slide which shows the activities and the integration?
I'll explain it. Okay.
Okay.
Just a minute. Let me check here. Yeah, you can see my screen, right?
Mm-hmm.
So how the process is moving, just let us understand this one. See, first of all, idea is coming, and that time it is in a PPM, portfolio project management, idea management, SAP PPM. Then detailed planning. Construction, and handover, SAP PS. Then,
so planning and budgeting cannot be done in PPM?
No.
Okay.
Lease in. Lease out, service charge, settlement. Okay, this will be done in SAP, and accounting, asset accounting will also be here. Asset accounting integrated to this one. Okay, so this is REFX, some part of asset accounting which is comes under the IFRS. Then once it is handed over, once the tenant is started to stay in this, that plant maintenance. Okay, here we call it as a facility management also. This is a part of SAP PM. So process wise, it is going like this. Even if we are going again on second level of detailing it out, so here in place of idea management, before that we can have strategy management also. Strategy management, that is a SAP SSM.
What is that, new module?
No, this is old module, but it is latest one is very good now. This is a SSM. Strategy management. Strategy management. We are calling it as a strategy management, SSM. Okay, so here we need to decide the strategy. According to the strategy, the idea should be generated. Strategy means if we are in the real estate market, our idea should also be related to real estate market. Not like I just want to go for any manufacturing of any electronics item or electrical item. So this is just again filtered on this PPM based. And then whatever the idea is coming, then it is being executed here. And once it is executed, then we are running, we are operating it with the help of REFX, and all the maintenance will be done with the help of plant maintenance. Here, one more thing came in lease, this scenario, the land use, okay? Land use, how you can manage your lands. Okay, so this REFX can be integrated with GIS system, and the coordinates can be defined, and you can see in your system within a map that where this property exactly situated. Okay, so let me come back here. Okay, so F8, F5. Yeah, investment, sales and marketing. Here we are doing campaign, lease and space management. This is REFX, maintenance, repair. These are, so this is a complete cycle how we are moving. Property master setup.
This is what I was looking at.
So this is a purely REFX here. Product setup, site building, land and rental unit, splitting, the amalgamation, leasing scenario, new lease, renewal, pre-termination, extension, holdover, transfer and sublet, leasing processes. Okay, so it, how we are moving, see, we are having the master data, then we are doing the marketing, then we are searching the rental unit based on the prospect requirement, then we are offering him, then contract will be created, then we will execute the contract. So contract can be terminated here, or if it is renewal, again it will come in the same cycle.
This is all lease out, right?
Yeah, lease out. Similarly, can be the leasing scenario also. Okay. And next, as if whatever we have discussed till now here what are the modules coming in that particular area within a construction, investment planning, property acquisition. So when we are doing the investment planning, that time property, how we need to execute, acquire the property or land, project construction of the project, then we are doing the campaign, lead and opportunity, it is being done, the sales and marketing, and then lease administration. This is a part where we are executing the REFX master data, we are creating real estate search, contract offer, then facility management, again it's a part of PM, space management, move management, and room reservation.
Okay,
so here I have just explained here what is the company, what is the site. Site means business entity, how it is created within a company. Okay, building and land, how it can be create as a business, different master data. Within a building, we can have pooled space. The area which is not having any wall, we call it as a pooled space. And again, the rental space, we can mark some area within a pooled space to rent it out. Similarly, the area which is having the wall within a building, we call it as a rental unit. So here, rental unit is the place, or rental, the rental space is the object where we are executing the contract. Okay, this we have taken one example. Company is ABC company, site is Pearl Center building. These are the different buildings we have, and these are the rental unit.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, then this in system, how it looks like. There's a real estate search. We are entering all this information, and system is getting all this search result based on the characteristics which we have defined in the master data. Okay, so this is a screen where I got all the search result.
This is basically to find out a unit which is available or
Yeah. This is the. Okay, and here lease out offer by copying the whatever the proposed by system.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, then we are creating an offer. So lease out contract, we can create a lease out contract here, and real estate billing, how we can execute the contract. So some of the screen I have selected here. So I'll show you all these things in system when we will go for the sessions.
Yeah.
Okay, this is to just make you understand. Okay, so that the new person who's not having idea can have some glance, some idea about the system.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, again, for the facility management, how we can integrate with different system here. Mm-hmm. Move management within a PM, how we are moving the system. Room reservation, maintenance, repair, and service management. This is the part, facility management. Reporting and dashboard, we are having some standard dashboard here. So this is not in a standard, this is a BU report.
Okay.
How it is integrated? It is integrated with FI, plant maintenance, project system, PS and IM, treasury, TR, we can integrate, fixed asset, asset accounting, and profit center accounting, we can integrate it. And GIS, how we can integrate with the CAD and GIS system. That's it. So I think you were also, for you it was already clear, and other people, no one is joined today.
Hmm.
No problem.
So I mean, yeah, I mean, so I had one question. I'm particularly interested, as you know, on the IFRS 16. So can can we first start with lease out scenario?
Yes, we will take the same scenario, lease out first. See, what we will follow, I'll explain first, because again and again, I'm explaining from the starting when we are talking about portfolio. So one
once
session, I'll
give you overview, and then probably instead of leasing,
yes,
we can start with lease out, yeah.
So first we'll take lease out, then lease in, it is similar, there's no much difference. Okay, mm-hmm. Lease out, then service charge settlement, then all the whatever the inside topics are coming, I'll cover.
No, I'm sorry, I said it the wrong way. IFRS 16 is basically lease in. So can we start with lease in?
Okay, yeah? Lease in, we can select any cycle, no problem on it. Okay,
so yeah, fair enough. So I don't know if others will be joining or not, but I will definitely be interested. So when can we start?
Okay, I'll confirm. Tomorrow I'll confirm. Okay.
Okay.
because already one batch is going on. I just need to finish. I think in this week or next week it will be finished. So immediately I'll start.
Okay, fair enough.
Okay.
Okay.
Yeah. Yeah. Thank you. Thank you, Yogesh.
Okay. Thank you very much.
Bye-bye. Bye.
Okay. Bye.